Hi everyone, it's Emmanuel here. Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I want to show you how you can use GetResponse to create free landing pages. If you are an internet marketer, you know how important landing pages are, and you need a landing page for every campaign you are going to run, right? So your landing page is more like a step in the way before you get your traffic, your leads to the main product or to the main website. So if you are into e-commerce, you're an affiliate marketer, whatever you do basically that involves you selling online, right? And if it involves you running paid ads, especially, you need a landing page, right? First, to let people know, to give people more details about what you are trying to sell or what you are trying to promote, and also to capture the details of the traffic you are getting, right? And this will help you build an email list and also remarket to them later on, follow up with them without spending further on ads, right? So in this video, I'll show you how you can use GetResponse to create landing pages, right? And if you don't have a GetResponse account, all you just have to do is to click the link in the description below and create a new GetResponse account. And you are going to have a 30 days free period where you can try all the premium features on GetResponse for free. Earlier in this video here, I talked about GetResponse and how it can help you make money online, right? So if you need a step-by-step tutorial on how to sign up to GetResponse, you can just check this video out. Also, I'll leave a link to it in the description. But in this video, I want to show you how you can create landing pages with GetResponse, right? So once you are logged into your GetResponse account, by the way, if you get value from this video, please give this video a like. I really appreciate that. Also, if this is your first time of visiting this channel, you're welcome. On this channel, I create videos that help you make money online. I create videos related to online business. And if that's something you are interested in, if you want to see more of my content in the future, just tap the subscribe button right now. Also, turn on notifications so that you don't miss any upload I make on this channel, right? So with that said, let me remind you again, make sure you give this video a like. That really go a long way. Now, to create a landing page with GetResponse, whatever the purpose of your landing page, right? All you need to do is to come over to the menu icon here. As you can see, you can just click create landing page, but you can come over to menu and then select landing pages, right? So on this space here, you want to click create landing page. And the way GetResponse work is very simple, right? You have templates that you can choose from. So all you need to do is pick a template that describes what you want to achieve, right? So if you want lead capturing, if you just want to give more details, whatever it is you want to do, you just select a template that suits you, right? You just select a template that you like. So as you can see, there are a lot of templates here, right? It's more like Canva, just a drag and drop tool. So all you need to do is to edit what's going to be here, right? So let me pick one of these templates here. Okay, let me see. All right, let me pick this. All right, so just select the template you want to use. So I'll select template, right? So you can preview the landing page and you can preview the thank you page as well, right? So see what's on the landing page here. Then you can name your landing page if you want. Let me name this example landing page. Then you click on next step. So please wait, Monster is loading your template. So let this just load. All right, so that's done. You don't have any scheduled webinar. I'll just cancel this. All right, so this is what we have here, right? So as you can see, at the top bar here, you see tools you can use. This, the desktop view, you can view it on mobile to see what your landing page and your thank you page will look like on mobile, right? Then you can add HTML codes to your landing page if you want to. You can check the settings here, right? Then here, these buttons here, you can use to save, edit, save as template. Then once you are done, you can click next step, right? But before we click next step, we are going to finish designing our landing page first, right? So, and if by the right here, you see these tools that you have access to. If you want to add a section to your work, you can do that here, right? Now, you use this if you want the product to be on GetResponse. That's, people can download from here or people can pay and get your product here, right? So, it's more like setting up an online store here, right, using this drop box here. Then here, if you want to add text, you can just drag this in, right, to add text. You can add images using this icon here. You drag in your image icon, then you add the image you want to add. Here you can add buttons, right, drag in the button, then you can customize it to whatever you want to do. Here you can add forms, right, static form, pop-up forms, right, whichever one you like, you just drag in. Everything here is just drag and drop, right? If I want to add pop-up forms, I'll just drag in, right? Then you select the type of form you want it to be, and whatever it is, you just do the customizations here. If you want it to be a sign up form, exit form, exit pop-up, download form, and all those things, right, you just choose that. Then here you can add shapes, square, circle, horizontal lines, vertical lines, right? You can add a timer to your landing page as well using this timer icon here, right? So let me remove all this. Also, you can add a video using this icon here. Then you can add your social media handles. You can link your PayPal to receive payment, right? Or you can edit, you can use the HTML editor here to edit your landing page, right? So if we come over back to the landing page, right? So usually you want your landing page to be very simple, because your landing page is not the main thing, right? It's just like a step to where you are directing people to, right? So you can just change this to your logo, right? So let's say I want to replace this image. Here's what I clicked. I click on this image icon here, and then you want to click on add files. So let me just bring in a file from my computer. So I'll just use this image I just added here, right? So this logo, this becomes the logo here, right? So here you just want to add the main subject of your landing page, right? And this usually describes what the people you are attracting are looking for, right? So here you just type in what you are offering, right? So let's say I'm offering a free ebook. Yes, I want to give this, the people will be coming to this landing page, a free ebook. I'll just type in, all right, let me just use a free video instead, right? So all these ones here, I'll just delete all of these. All right, so let's say we have this, then I can bring in another text here. All right, so I'll just edit my text. All right, also I can just drag this wide. Then I can also change the text alignment here, right? Can center align from the left, align from the right. So let me just centralize it, right? So have this. Also, I can change the text inside the button here. Let me just change this to show me the video. All right, so let's say this is what I have. Then at the bottom here, you can just do some editing, right? Just add the benefits, further details of, let's say here that I'm giving away a free video. You can just add more details about the video, what they should expect from the video. If I have testimonials, I can add them here, right? Whatever it is you want to do. And I can also add another form here, right? I could easily duplicate this form, or I could just come here and add a form directly from here, right? Or I will just bring in the section first, right? Add the section here, then bring in this form to this section, right? So that they can fill here. I can just delete this, right? So here, after entering all the benefits that we get from this video, right? Let's say these are the benefits here. Use watch video. All right. So when creating my landing pages, I like keeping things simple, right? You don't want to bug this place with too many details. You don't want to bug this place with too many details, right? So simplicity is key, except if you want this to be the final page they will get to before they make payment, or before they get the product you want them to get. Then you can add all of the details about your offer or about your product here, right? So, but if this is not the main page right? All you just want to do here is to get their details. Then you want to keep it as simple as possible, right? All right, so once I'm done editing here, I want to come over to the mobile version and ensure that what I have in the mobile version is in place, right? So I can just edit some part of this. Now this so that people will be visiting this page from their mobile phones will also have a good experience on the page, right? So I'll just edit this to suit, right? Just increase the font size. All right. Okay. So let's say we have this. All right. So I'll just adjust all of this. Okay. So this, bring it here to the center. Right. So let's say we have this on mobile. And then we have this on desktop. Also, you want to come down to the bottom here, right? And then change this copyright. Let's say I'll just enter my name here. And then here, you want to add your social media links, right? So just double click and then select. Let me copy my Facebook link here. And then come over here and then just paste the link and then click OK. You can do the same for Twitter, double click and then select this link icon. Same thing for Instagram, double click and you have that, right? So that people can click on these icons and follow you to those platforms, right? So once you are done with the landing page, you want to come over to the thank you page, and then the thank you page is where you want to put in further instructions, right? After they are filled in their email and name, what should they expect next, right? So I'll just delete that logo, right? Thank you for signing up. Okay, let me just say thank you for signing up and bring this to the center, and then could just use check your email. The link to the free video has been sent to your email, right? Or on this thank you page, you can just add the video for them to watch, let's say for instance, or you can just here use a link or use a button to give them the link to download whatever you are offering, right? Or you can just from the landing page here, just after submitting this video, you direct them to, after clicking the submit button, they get redirected to the main website straight up. So you can do that any way you like. So I'll just delete all of this and then I'll just leave it as simple as this, right? Bring this to the center as well. Then I'll check the mobile version. Let's see what we have. Okay, we have this and I'm just going to leave it this way, right? So once you are done with all the editing changes and everything you want to do, the next thing you want to do is to click on save and then you click on next step. All right, so here you want to title your page. You can give it any name you want, right? You can add a description if you want. If you want to enable SEO for this page, you can just check this box, right? But here is going to be the link to your landing page, right? And if you have a custom domain, you can add it here and use that link, right? Then subscription settings, you choose the list you want people, these subscribers to get added to, right? So if you have multiple lists created, you can just select the list you want to add them to inside GetResponse. Then if you want them to confirm opt-in before they can be added to your list, right? This will increase your chances of your messages landing in their inbox, right? So you can leave this confirm opt-in on, but if you don't want that, you can turn it off, right? So depending on what you want. So if the confirmed opt-in is on, they'll need to confirm joining your email list before they'll start getting all the messages and the autoresponders you have set up for this list. Okay, so here you want to select the day of your sequence you want to add them to, right? So once people sign up to this email list, let's say they join day zero and get the message for day zero, then here after they click submit, where do you want to redirect them to, right? Do you want to take them to the default landing page, the one we just customized, or you want to take them to another website or another landing page or just somewhere else? You can just choose custom thank you page and then enter the link you want to redirect them to, right? But let's say I want to take them to the default landing page we have here. I'll select that. Or if you don't want to take them anywhere, you click stay on current page, they get added to your email list, and that's all, right? So let me use default landing page. Then here you see analytics and marketing. Right here is where you can install Facebook Pixel, Google Tag Manager, and all those things. You can do that here. You can install your Facebook Pixel, whatever you want to do. You can add Google Ads conversion trafficking if you want to. So you have all these features for you here. And then once you are done with all the settings here, all you need to do is to click on publish to publish your landing page, right? So just give it a moment and it, right? So that is done. So this is the link to my landing page here. So I can just open a new tab. Let me see what we've got. All right, so this is what we have here, and then people can go ahead and enter their name, email to get the video I'm promising them, right? So this is how simple it is to create landing pages on GetResponse, right? And you can create as many landing pages as you want, but if you're on the free plan, after the 30 days period, only one of those landing pages will be working, right? So this is how you create landing pages on GetResponse and get your internet business and marketing moving, right? So I hope this video helps you, and if it does, make sure you give it a like. And that's all I have for you guys in today's video. If you had to subscribe to the channel, make sure you subscribe before you go, and I'll see you guys in the next video.